Well, hello everyone. Welcome to episode 2 of Misfits TV. We are so glad that you've decided to tune in with us tonight. How are you doing, JD?
I'm very well. Yeah, how are you going?
I'm 10 out of 10. It's been such a good week. What's been happening, Jed?
Well, we started our week off with church, which was just awesome, wasn't it?
It was so good.
It's so cool that we can still gather together on a Sunday. I love that we're able to do that. What did we do on Tuesday?
Tuesday, we had our very first Zoom hangout, our Zoom party. We had some Star Wars trivia, which was awesome.
Due
to the fact that it was May the 4th on the Monday previous.
Yes, I actually did pretty well. Like, I wouldn't say I'm like I like Star Wars, but I'm not like hardcore Star Wars fan.
Yeah. But shout out to Logs. Logs did a great job.
He did.
Really nailed that Star Wars trivia.
Yeah, the Ewok Yoda thing was, that was hard.
Yeah, it was tricky, but you know what? It was worth it. It's always worth keeping your eye out for those little critters, huh?
Yeah, and I've been really enjoying our Misfit Mornings on Instagram.
Misfit Mornings. Yeah. Truth be told, we actually didn't do one like we promised for this morning.
No, but that's okay.
But we're here now.
We're here.
We're here doing Misfits TV, and it's going to go all right. Hey, guess what? Tonight we are introducing some new segments in the show.
Yeah.
Two new segments.
Wow. It's incredible.
It's going to be fantastic. And the first one is by our very, very favorite Pokemon extraordinaire, Mr. Colin Friend. Now, Colin has blessed us today. Well, he's blessing us the whole week, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's getting us ready for our week ahead.
He's preparing us. Colin is a prepared man, and he's preparing us with his new segment, Weather with Col.
The weather today was pleasantly warm with plenty of sunshine. Looking ahead, on Saturday we're expecting mostly snubble and warm with a shuckle in spots and natto in the afternoon. Sunday will be cooler with plenty of swin up. There will be plenty of slugma on Monday and sunkern on Tuesday. On Wednesday, look out for quillfish and Virizion. Finally, on Thursday, it'll be mostly spinnerack with a couple of merrill in the afternoon.
Colin, that was great.
I had no idea that he could integrate so many Pokemon within a weekly weather forecast. It's quite the impressive skill.
It is, and now we don't have to do the research on our own for the week.
Absolutely, we're good to go. We are good to go. I can't wait for the weeks ahead with Colin introducing more Pokemon and more weather forecasts.
Yeah, really looking forward to it.
Speaking of segments, we have a brand new segment right now, which I found particularly difficult this week because it was focused on me.
Yes, just for this week.
For this week, I was the loser, you were the chooser in our 24-hour TikTok challenge. Why don't you check it out? Okay, earlier tonight, we Zoomed with the whole Misfit leadership team and we figured out who was going to be the loser and the chooser for our TikTok in 24 hours. Turns out, it was me. Who is it? I can't see.
It's you, mate.
Are you serious? And everyone voted for Jay to be the chooser.
Can we just vote who gets to pick?
I vote Jay.
I vote myself.
Are we just happy with Jay choosing?
Yes.
Okay, Jade it is. So she's currently looking at different TikToks for me to try and replicate within a 24-hour period.
I'm looking. Well, I'm not on TikTok, so I'm not sure what's, like, happening, what's good. They're not that funny. That's all right, you know. I throw her suddenly, I think it was school tomorrow. I just don't know. I want you to do a dancing one. What's, like, some good dance ones? No. I found it. I have found the one that Gil must do. It's so good. But it's a remix of ScoMo's press conference.
Andrew, I'm sorry, you've had several questions. Andrew, I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay?
Great. So we found it.
Yeah.
ScoMo remix. What's the time now, Jade?
It is 8:34 on a Tuesday evening.
Wednesday evening, 8:34. I have to have something to show for myself. Challenge on.
So it's the morning after the challenge was given to me. I am pretty thankful. I feel like it's a pretty easy one. What's going to be tricky is learning the words word for word. So I think my strategy at the moment is this: try and just watch the press conference over and over and over, and try and just get used to saying Andrew.
I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay? So I'm going to go to other questions of members of the group. Catherine hasn't had a question. I'm happy to return to you, but let's just keep it civil. Andrew. Catherine.
Andrew, I'm sorry. Andrew, I know, but you don't know. So the update right now is I went with my tactic. I watched the press conference. I wrote down the script, word for word, trying to get my, the stutters. He does a lot of stutters, I've realized. So nailing that's going to be tricky. It's just going to be about making the words fit with the mouth, like making it sound like I'm saying it. But look, got my script here, ready to go to... Ready to go to try and make this the best TikTok that we can.
Go to other questions of the members of the... Andrew.
Catherine. Now there!
I'm getting better, I'm getting close. Andrew, I'm sorry, Andrew. I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay? Keep it simple. Andrew.
Okay, I've done a lot of listening, a lot of watching. I think we're into draft time.
You've had several questions. Andrew, I'm sorry. Andrew, I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay? So I'm going to go to other questions of members. Catherine hasn't had a question. You've had several questions. Andrew, I'm sorry. Andrew, I know, but you don't run the press conference.
So it is currently 5:44. And Gil, have you done it?
I believe so. I think we've achieved what we needed to achieve.
He thinks he's done the TikTok.
Yeah. I just need to write my caption and then... off it goes.
He made the deadline. It's impressive. Yeah. I'm impressed.
Great. First time around, made it happen.
Yeah.
Great.
Andrew, I'm sorry. You've had several questions. Andrew, I'm sorry. Andrew, I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay? So I'm going to go to other questions of members of the group. Catherine hasn't had a question. I'm happy to return to you, but let's just keep it civil. Andrew. Catherine.
Well, I don't know if I am biased, but I think you did a really good job.
Thank you.
I'm really impressed that you were able to learn all of that in less than 24 hours and deliver a quality TikTok. A
lot of blood, a lot of sweat,
yeah.
A lot of tears.
I'm not on it at the moment, but that was, I was like, wow, maybe I should be a part of this platform.
Yeah,
see more of Gil.
Well... we'll see. If I'm the loser again, you'll see more of me. Hopefully not.
Yeah.
Hopefully there is less of Gil on TikTok and more of our other leaders.
Yes.
If you want to have a crack at one of our TikTok challenges or you want to join in, just let us know in the comments or hit us up on social media and we'll give you a challenge straight away. We can't wait to see the TikToks that you guys will be creating in a 24-hour period.
Were you thinking of anyone in particular when you wrote that caption?
Okay, guys, now we are coming to the teaching element of our night. And we are continuing in our new series called Stay. And I'm excited to share about this one.
Yeah, it's really good.
This one has a personal story, personal anecdote of mine.
Yeah.
So keep watching the screen and check out our next teaching element. Hey, everyone. Welcome to our second week of teaching from our new series, Stay. We're looking at different spiritual disciplines that we should continue to practice even though the rest of our lifestyle might look very different. And this week, I want to encourage us in this idea, staying in prayer. I think that we should be people who don't give up praying even in a time like this. But before we get into that, I want to introduce you to someone.
You in?
How are you, mate?
Good, mate. How's things?
Yeah, not too bad.
This is my mate, Simon. And Simon and I have known each other for over 20 years. We went to the same preschool. We played in the same soccer teams. And we even ended up going to the same high school.
And we'd actually hang out quite a bit. We used to catch the same bus home. We used to try out for the same sports teams. We used to be in a band together. We used to be in some of the same classes. We actually became quite good friends. And that didn't change all the way through high school, into uni, into when we were working full time, because Simon and I got ourselves into a routine. You see, we'd call each other at least twice a week. So every week we'd dial up and we'd talk about what's going on in the news, who's gonna win the footy on the weekend, what's the new band that we're listening to, just whatever's going on in our lives. We'd make sure we'd catch up at least twice a week. And this was something that was in the diary. We would never miss it. We'd always chat at least twice a week. But just earlier this year, something has happened. You see, Simon met a wonderful girl that he ended up getting married to. And the thing about this girl is that she's actually from England. So with his new wife, Simon decided that they were going to move over to Leeds indefinitely. Now this changes everything. You can't just call someone up and have a chat or drop by on your way home from somewhere when they live on the other side of the world. That's just not possible anymore. And this got me thinking. I reckon right now, a lot of people are feeling this way in regards to their relationship with God. Maybe you're feeling this way right now. Maybe you haven't even thought to pray to God or speak to God since isolation has happened. Well, tonight I want to encourage us in two things that I think will help us be people who stay in prayer. The first one is this, to draw close. God isn't a God who lives in a church building or lives in a temple. You read through the whole Bible and how many times do you see God speaking to people outside of the synagogues or the temples? God spoke to people wherever they were at, and that's how God can relate to us. We don't need to be in church. We don't need to be in the building to talk to God. John 15:4 tells us, "Abide in me and I will abide in you." And this is Jesus speaking, and he's saying, if you draw close to me, if you come close and be relational with me, I will be relational with you. That's what Jesus is saying here. So we need to find new ways to be relational with Jesus. Maybe we were people who relied on church or youth group or Bible study to be the moment in our week where we pray to God, but those things can't happen in the same way. So we need to find new ways in which we can draw close to Jesus. So I want to ask that question. Have you been drawing close to Jesus lately? The second thing I think we can do to be people who stay in prayer is this. I think we can be intentional. You see, for Simon and I, we have to be super intentional now about catching up with one another. So we have to text in advance and say, okay, man, Sydney time, 6 p.m. How does that work out for you? Let's try Tuesday. Okay, that's not going to work. What about this day? You see, we have to plan in advance and make sure that our weeks match up in order for us to catch up like we used to. See, Colossians 4:2 tells us this. Pray diligently, stay alert with your eyes wide open in gratitude. Now, I love that term, being diligent prayers. People who are being diligent and sensible and finding time to pray with gratitude. So maybe you need to do something like that in your week. Maybe you need to start your day and say, every morning when I'm having breakfast, once I finish breakfast, I'm gonna pray. Or maybe you need to set a reminder in your phone, or maybe the first 5 minutes of your lunch or your recess break is gonna be a chance for you to pray. But you need to schedule that in, and you need to be responsible and diligent in finding these moments in your week where you can pray. So as we finish up tonight, I just want to encourage you to be a person who stays in prayer. Don't let it go by the wayside like a bunch of other things are doing right now, but be someone who prioritizes it, be someone who is diligent about it, and be someone who is going to stay in prayer. And if you don't know what to pray about, just be a friend with God. Just pray like you would be having a conversation with someone else. How's your week been? What's been going on? How are you feeling about this thing or that thing? Just find time to meet with God. Abide in him and he will abide in you. All right, mate, well, I'll catch you soon.
Yeah, mate, good to chat. Speak to you after.
Well, thank you, Gil, for that really encouraging word. Simon's such a legend, isn't he?
He is, he is. But stay in prayer, children.
Yes, stay in prayer.
Stay in school, stay in prayer.
Love it. So good.
Yeah.
Well, we have some really cool things coming up next week in the life of Misfits, don't we?
We do. We do. Mm. We're actually not having a Misfits TV, which is tragic.
It is tragic.
But at the same time, by the same token, it's actually fantastic because we have Fuse coming up.
Mm.
Fuse is going to be live streamed from Fresh Hope Youth's Facebook page. We'll get the details out on social media in some way, some shape, some
You'll
form.
You'll still see a familiar face. Gil will feature in it for quite a bit. But the exciting thing about Fuse is that we're going to be launching our Uprising Camp and our Drastic Camp for this year. So you have to tune in to find out what is going on.
You got to be there. It's going to be great. Otherwise, we're going to be hitting you guys up on social media throughout the week with our Misfit Mornings. Remember, Zoom parties on Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. And I just wish you guys a good week.
Yeah, and if you guys need to chat, hang out with Gil and I, just reach out. We will be there either online or maybe even face-to-face in a heartbeat, won't we, Gil?
We love you guys.
Yeah.
We're wishing you the best and we'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Bye.